In this video, I will be exploring weeb music and the broader concept of weeb. What is weeb music? How does this classification differ from genre? What is genre? What is weeb? Weeb. You know it when you see it. Just kidding. I will present the best and most parsimonious definition I could think of. I choose to use this term despite its potential flaws because it is the most broadly used colloquial term for the concept that I am trying to discuss. Weeb is a mode of expression. Weeb can be used to express any emotion or idea, but in a characteristic style. This is similar to how anime is a medium which can depict anything, but is still recognizable as anime. Weeb media is media expressed through weeb, or expressed in a weeb manner. If an artistic creation is weeb, then it is usually identifiable as such to weebs, weebs being people who like weeb media and are usually self-identified as such. So we understand how weeb is classified as a mode of expression with a distinct flavor, but not exactly what that flavor is yet. To understand this, we have to understand the weeb condition, in which I believe the heart of weeb is contained. This is potentially controversial, but this concept is the core of my definition. Japanese otaku media evolved from previously existing anime and manga, and came into its own in the 90s and 2000s with works such as Neon Genesis Evangelion and Welcome to the NHK, which were made by otaku for otaku. These otaku were experiencing the Japanese otaku condition, characterized by a very specific experience in a very specific economic and cultural context. Feelings of social isolation and retreating from the expectations of being a married, bread-winning businessman in a failing economy into neatdom and fantasy. Andrea Horbinski characterized this classic otaku media revolution of the 90s, along with its fujoshi counterpart, as a countercultural movement rebelling against norms in Japanese society at the time. Japanese otaku media changed anime forever. Works like Evangelion influenced virtually all anime produced after it. Moe and idols became more popular in otaku media in the 2000s, and otaku-influenced anime proliferated throughout Japanese pop culture and was exported overseas. It connected to people overseas who identified with the weeb condition. I will define the weeb condition as trouble connecting to people and society, possibly coupled with an obsessive nature, necessarily coupled with enjoyment or emotional attachment to weeb media. Weeb media indexes the weeb condition and serves as escapism or emotional fulfillment. However, since anime has grown so popular in Japan and overseas, being a weeb is no longer as niche and otaku as before. The result of this is that media which take artistic influence from classic otaku media and therefore indexes the weeb condition aren't necessarily directly inspired by it or even related to it at all. Therefore, it makes sense to me that there are gradations of weebness. How weeb something is directly correlated to how much it indexes the weeb condition, specifically through artistic expression influenced by classic otaku media. At this point, most weeb media has branched out far from its origin, but still has a distinctive weeb flavor. Even completely pop, as opposed to countercultural otaku media, can be weeb, if it employs the same artistic techniques like art style and music style, which act as genre markers for weeb. Now, we could finally fully define weeb. Weeb is a form of expression influenced by Japanese otaku media and broader Japanese culture, such as kawaii culture, which, in its unique expressive mode, indexes the weeb condition to some extent, either through direct cultural connection or artistic genre markers. Now on to weeb music. Simply put, weeb music is weeb media, so therefore indexes weeb, or has artistic lineage, shares characteristics, or is otherwise related to things that do. When thinking of the most weeb music in existence, I inevitably think of Vocaloid. I have a theory as to why Vocaloid is so weeb. It has many characteristics that index the weeb condition. Most of the vocals are cute, awkward, sometimes clunky, and don't sound fully human. It seems that some people like Vocaloid because they find its characteristics endearing. To illustrate this point, there's a YouTube comment below Last Night Goodnight by KZ Livetune featuring Hatsune Miku, which reads, "I remember when I first heard this song, back in July of 2009. When I wasn't having all that great of a time in high school, hearing something so foreign, so unique, it made me believe that if this music had a place in the world, then perhaps I did too. I'm not saying that this represents everyone who likes Vocaloid, but I think this is an important part of why Vocaloid connects with so many people, especially outside of Japan. One of the most important things which led me to creating this framework was reading interviews with Vocaloid producers. Kenshi Yonezu, also known as Hachi, said in an interview, "I've had a notion from long ago that I was a monster, that I wasn't normal." His feeling of being disconnected from other people is why he hid his face and voice behind Vocaloid. Ironically, he's now one of the most popular J-pop artists in existence. Similar ideas were reflected in interviews with producers like Wawaka and Deco 27. Vocaloid gave them a voice through which they could express themselves. Because most Vocaloid songs are coupled with anime art style, and the Vocaloid itself sounds weeb, Vocaloid can be said to be some of the most authentically weeb music in existence. Mafu Mafu, the most popular utaite, is known as a shut-in. He even called one of his concerts, which sold out to tens of thousands of people, Hiki Fest, short for Hikikomori Festival. In fact, it's kind of a meme how many anime and Vocaloid and utaite media feature Hikikomori characters and themes. Many Vocaloid and utaite songs feature dark themes like depression and suicide. Neru, a Vocaloid producer and Vocaloid's resident edgelord, includes social critique in pretty much all of his songs. This is reminiscent of classic otaku media's countercultural nature. It could be said that Vocaloid is very countercultural. Notably, I've been discussing music, but I haven't mentioned genre once. That is because weeb music is not a genre, at least according to my survey data and according to most people that I've talked to. Weeb music, rather than a genre, is a distinct global music partitioning, which I will call the GMP. I will define a GMP as a partitioning in an individual's mind of the sum of all music they've heard into arbitrary categories. For example, an individual's subjective concept of genre, certainly influenced by the surrounding culture's concepts of genre, but nevertheless individual and subjective. Or their genre partitioning is a subconscious, or sometimes conscious, categorization of all the music they know into categories called genres. Another example of a GMP is moods. Someone, when asked to categorize a song based on mood, will have their own subjective mood partitioning GMP. They will classify the song based on which emotions are indexed. Weeb partitioning is a GMP that has the classifications weeb and non-weeb, and maybe some stuff in between. Genre indexes cultural background, mood indexes emotion. Weeb indexes the weeb mode of expression. That's why weeb isn't a genre in the sense that most people think of genre. Most people don't agree that weeb is a genre because there is weeb music of a ton of different genres. I did a survey. Since the sample size was small, I won't say it's representative, but there is interesting stuff that we could find out. First, I asked people if there was such a thing as weeb music. Everyone except one person said yes, and no one said no. I asked them to define weeb music, and most people said something along the lines of anime or anime-adjacent music, Vocaloid, J-pop, etc. Then I asked people to classify 49 songs on a scale from 0 to 4, 0 being extremely not weeb, 1 being not weeb, 2 being slightly weeb, 3 being weeb, 4 being extremely weeb. And there are some interesting things we could find out. For example, first of all, I included controls like Kanye West and Chopin, which were, as expected, have a very low average score. Then I included weeb controls, which, as expected, had extremely high scores, all above 3, like Lucky Star opening. Stuff with Vocaloid was generally considered weeb. There was an experimental noise band featuring Hatsune Miku, which was kind of strange, but still had an average of 2.3. Miku singing jazz was given a 3. Servant of Evil, the part with Vocaloid, was given a 2.8 and had a mode of 4, but the instrumental version only got 1 with a mode of 0. So it seems that the Vocaloid makes it Weeb. Vocaloid in different languages. Oliver, Secrets of Wisteria, in English, was pretty Weeb. A Chinese Vocaloid, Luo Tianyi, was given a 2, but with a mode of 4, so pretty controversial. Who knows if it's Weeb? The Urku cover of that same song had a mode of 4 and an average of 2.3. Rap was generally considered less Weeb. Baby metal was considered pretty Weeb. A metal Vocaloid song had an average of 2 but a mode of 1, so maybe not so Weeb. Naruse's cover of Lazy Song by Bruno Mars was definitely not Weeb. Probably no one noticed that it was Naruse. I did an experiment where I included several versions of Kagero Days. The instrumental version, as expected, was the least Weeb, but still fairly Weeb at 2. The English female cover was more Weeb at 2.5. The male English cover was about the same. The Japanese male cover was 2.9. The Japanese female cover was 3. And the Vocaloid version was about 3.1. Older Japanese songs and anime openings were not considered very Weeb, whereas most newer anime openings were. And instrumental covers of these anime openings were generally considered fairly Weeb. An English cover of Renai Circulation was considered very Weeb. The instrumental part of Tokyo Ghoul Opening 2 was considered less Weeb than the vocal part, which makes sense. Idle Stuff Across the Board was extremely Weeb, even the instrumental. The instrumental version got an average of 3 and a mode of 4, so incredibly Weeb, even with no vocals. A Radwim song in English was considered not very Weeb, but for the most part, newer J-pop, even if it's not from anime, was considered Weeb. Lemon was on the border of Weeb with a mode of 2 and an average of 1.8. That's all. Obviously, I've only scratched the surface of Weeb. Here are some of the biggest questions that remain for me. How is Weeb conceived of in Japan versus the Western fandom, or other anime fandoms like in China? Much like how Deborah Wong described Taiko as a broader Asian American identity, it seems like Weeb culture and K-pop have fulfilled that role to an even greater degree. Most importantly, is Weeb even a valid concept? There are, of course, many more questions that I haven't even thought of. I want to further explore this concept and related concepts. I need other people to join in on the research and exchange ideas. Many people were interested when I presented this idea to them. I want to legitimize talking about this, and I want it to evolve into something beyond myself. Thank you.